Hi, I'm Cody Smith with Cloyes Gear and Products. In this video, I'm going to show you how to service the time and chain system in the 97 to 2011 Ford 4.0 single overhead cam engines using Cloyes aftermarket replacement components and the special Ford 4.0 timing toolkit. All right, here's the components we're going to be using today. This is our 9-0398 SB kit. It's going to come with the time and chain cassettes, the tensioners, guides, hydraulic tensioners, the sprockets, and the chains. This is for engines with a balance shaft. We also offer primary kits for engines without balance shafts, primary drive kits for both without balance shaft and with balance shaft. We offer a kit that comes with your balance shaft components, and then we offer the cassettes, both front and rear individually, and the hydraulic tensioners individually as well. Here's a look at the special Ford 4.0 timing toolkit we'll be using for our installation. This is our crankshaft positioning tool, the tensioner tool, the camshaft locking tool, the cam sprocket holding tool, and this is the cam sprocket bolt socket bracket for in-vehicle removal and installation. To begin, it is advised to pull the engine out of the vehicle for this repair. Access to the right bank components is very limited in the vehicle. Once the engine is out, you'll need to remove the front timing cover and the valve covers to access the timing drives. A few quick notes. In this video, I'll cover the case of timing repair due to a rattle or routine maintenance, not a complete system failure. For our demonstration, we will install components of the special toolkit to preset timing before removal of the old timing components. This will locate the crankshaft at number one top dead center and the camshaft in their appropriate locations. If the timing system has failed, there is a separate procedure and special tool for the removal and installation of the camshaft roller followers. Roller follower removal is required if rotating individual shafts is necessary. This is an interference engine. Before the removal of any components, install the crankshaft positioning tool on the harmonic balancer and ensure the positioning tool is against the engine block. This is to preset the timing drive at number one top dead center. Then install the camshaft locking tool on the right bank. Remove the right bank camshaft bolt. This is a left-hand threaded bolt. If the repair is being made in the vehicle, you will need to use the toolkit sprocket bolt socket bracket. Remove the engine compartment seal to gain access to the rear jackshaft sprocket attachment bolt. Then remove the bolt. Remove the right bank hydraulic tensioner from the outside of the head. Then remove the right bank cassette drive from the engine drive chest. We're now ready to install the right-hand bank cassette assembly. Before you install, make sure the orientation of the sprockets are correct. These are the counterbore features that will install on each respective shaft. Free spin install the camshaft sprocket bolt and the rear jackshaft sprocket bolt. Take care that the lower cassette guide pivot attachment mates properly to the block feature and that the specialty rubber O-ring headed bolt is in reusable condition. After the attachment bolt is torqued, the guide assembly must be free to pivot. Torque the bolt to 9 foot-pounds. Install upper cassette guide attachment bolt, ensuring that the bolt shoulder sleeve properly engages the cassette guide slot feature. Torque to 9 foot-pounds. Install tensioner tool, followed by the sprocket holding tool. Torque camshaft bolt to 45 foot-pounds using the sprocket socket bracket, or 63 foot-pounds with a torque wrench directly on the bolt. Using a backup wrench on the front jackshaft sprocket bolt, torque the rear jackshaft sprocket bolt to the torque to yield specifications, 15 foot-pounds plus 90 degrees. This is a torque to yield bolt and is not intended to be reused. Remove the tensioner tool and install the right bank hydraulic tensioner. Take care to use the new provided tensioner gasket. Torque to 32 foot-pounds. remove the sprocket holding tool, followed by the camshaft locking tool. Take care to not let the camshaft rotate during the remaining steps. Install the new engine compartment seal. Now we're ready to move to the front of the engine. We'll start by removing the left bank time and chain tensioner. Install the camshaft locking tool on the left bank. Remove the left bank camshaft sprocket bolt. Remove the crankshaft positioning tool. Make note of the position of the crankshaft key. It should be straight up at 12 o'clock. This is your reference frame of number one top dead center while the positioning tool is removed. During these next steps, take care not to let the crankshaft rotate from the number one top dead center location. Using a backup socket wrench on the harmonic balancer bolt, remove the front jackshaft sprocket bolt. Then remove the harmonic balancer bolt and the balancer. Remove the primary tensioner, followed by the primary guide. Now remove the primary chain, jackshaft sprocket, and the crank sprocket. Remove the cassette attachment bolts and the cassette assembly. Remove the balance shaft tensioner, followed by the balance shaft guide. Next, remove the balance shaft chain and balance shaft drive sprocket. Before we install the balance shaft drive components, go ahead and make sure the crankshaft is still at number one top dead center with the crank key at 12 o'clock. Install the balance shaft drive sprocket and the balance chain on the first step of the crankshaft. Now center the balance shaft unit timing hole with the two timing marks on the balance shaft sprocket while simultaneously installing the chain on the balance shaft sprocket. Now align and install the mel key feature of the balance shaft drive sprocket to the second step on the crankshaft. Next, install the balance shaft guide. Torque the bolts to 89 inch-pounds. Install the balance shaft tensioner. Torque bolts to 21 foot-pounds. Remove balance shaft tensioner activation pin. Confirm balance shaft timing is correct. Make sure the balance shaft unit timing hole is centered between the two timing marks on the balance shaft sprocket and the crankshaft key is at 12 o'clock. We're now ready to install the left bank cassette assembly. Once again, make sure the orientation of the sprockets are correct. These are the counterbore features that will index onto their respective shafts. Free spin install the camshaft sprocket bolt. Take care that the lower cassette guide pivot attachment mates properly to the block feature. Also, make sure that the upper specialty rubber O-ring headed bolt is in reusable condition. Torque upper O-ring bolt to 9 foot-pounds. And torque the pivot bolt to 14 foot-pounds. After the pivot bolt is torqued, the guide assembly must be free to pivot. Next, install your tensioner tool. Now we're ready to install the crank sprocket, the primary chain, and the jackshaft sprocket as one unit. Free spin install the front jackshaft bolt. Install the primary guide. Torque bolts to 14 foot-pounds. Install the primary tensioner. Torque bolts to 89 inch-pounds. Now install the camshaft sprocket holding tool, the harmonic balancer, and crankshaft positioning tool. Once again, with the positioning tool installed, confirm balance shaft timing is correct. Torque left-hand camshaft bolt to 63 foot-pounds. Torque front jackshaft bolt to 33 foot-pounds plus 90 degrees. This is a torque to yield bolt and is not intended to be reused. Remove the primary tensioner activation pin. Before you remove the special tools, ensure the crank positioning tool is still up against the block with the cam locking tool still installed on the left bank. Now install the camshaft locking tool on the right hand bank to ensure the camshaft is not turned during installation. Remove all timing tool components. Then install the left bank hydraulic tensioner. Take care to use the new provided tensioner gasket, torqued to 32 foot-pounds. Now that the timing system is installed, it is important to check the oil pressure restrictor rod and its port for sludge and debris. The nylon rod is a component in the oil porting system that has a critical role in oil feed. Remove the pipe plug located near the left bank hydraulic tensioner. Then remove the nylon rod. Inspect the oil port in the engine head for any debris or buildup. Clean the port if necessary. Clean the oil pressure restrictor rod and reinstall. Reinstall the pipe plug using a thread sealant. Before starting your engine, it is advised to prime the oil system by turning the engine over with the ignition system deactivated. This will hydraulically charge the tensioners. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, call me at the Cloyes Tech Line. Please subscribe to our channel.